You might have oil on your hands and grease on your shoes, but don't worry. We're back in the garage with Bodie Stroud.
Hello, and welcome back to In the Garage. With us right now is Shannon. Shannon, hey, we'll, I know you're going crazy with everything out in the rain, so we'll make it quick and let you go here, but
get back to wiping my car off.
Yeah, dang, that sucks. I've been there. We were at the show in Santa Barbara once, and the same thing just came pouring down. It was like, oh my God, because I usually don't take water to the cars that we build. You know, well, you know what it does. I mean, it's cool to drive them, but when you're driving them in the rain, it's something totally different.
Yeah, definitely not fun.
Nah, because, you know, they're our babies, and we want them to last forever, you know, and we put all this time and money into them, so. But anyways, yeah, we were saying before we left, you making the you know, old gauges work with all the new motors and components and stuff. You do that, right?
Yeah, well, you know, like doing the 6 to 12-volt conversion, you know, if it's a car that was originally a 6-volt car, all the gauges were working fine, still has the original engine, original transmission, drivetrain, and you just want to upgrade the gauges from 6 to 12-volt, then you can do like what you guys were talking about, where you just drop the voltage down to the original gauges. But that usually always requires that you have good working sending units if they're electric or if they're the mechanical gauges that are, you know, the water temperature gauge that's ether filled or the mechanical oil pressure gauge. You want to have all new lines and stuff like that.
Do you repair
normally
the old
what
mechanical?
We do, well, we don't actually repair the old mechanicals. There's not too many places in California where they'll allow you to use ether because of our EPA and all that.
Yeah.
The joke.
Gotcha.
The EPA that goes on in California. So we send them off to these back east companies in Ohio and stuff like that to repair the original mechanical water.
Oh, okay. But you can do it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
okay,
for sure.
Cool. All right.
But like I was saying before, like, you know, you get an old gauge cluster that looks cool and you want to put it in your 32 Ford or 33 or Chevy, whatever you want to do. You know, we put modern internals behind the original faces and then supply you with new sending units. And we'll typically use either, you know, VDO gauges, which are made in Germany, really good high-quality gauge, or Autometer. You know, Autometer gauges made in the USA, you know, we'll use their internals as well.
Oh, so that's cool. So, you know, that probably helps people out a lot, because I've got a lot of people come up to me and say, hey, I'm putting an LS7 in my, you know, my 32 Roadster or whatever. How do I make my gauges? I want the original gauges, you know, working in there. And
yeah, that's probably one of the most popular things going on in our shop right now is making all these gauges work with the modern LS drivetrain. Or if you're doing a new gen Hemi swap in an older Chrysler car or something like that, same deal. Is that, you know, with a lot of these speedometers, even we can convert them to electronic, so they'll have modern Autometer electronic programmable internals, so they'll work off of a car's computer. So if you have a computer that has a speed signal output or a tack signal output, we can make the gauges, you know, talk to the computer so that you can have all the original gauges functioning properly in the dash, which to me is just a lot, you know, it's a lot cooler looking when you're driving that car and you're looking at the original dash. Ornamental.
Versus
just, you know, putting a piece of sheet metal in there and popping in some dolphin gauges, you know. been there, done that. I don't want no porpoise gauges in my car.
Yeah. Well, hey, Shannon, I got to let you go. It's the end of the show already. I mean, it went by so fast. Holy moly, we usually need more than an hour. But, hey, good luck out there in the rain, and I'll talk to you soon. You know what I mean?
Thanks. Look us up, redlinegageworks.com, also on Facebook.
There you go. You got a phone number, too?
Yeah, it's 661-259-8891. Give us a call.
Cool. Thanks, Shannon. Appreciate it. We'll talk
to you
soon. Okay.
Take care. Bye.
Yep. Anyways, that's it for today's show. What do we got next week, Mitchell?
That went by real quick.
Yeah, geez.
Next week, I think we're going to talk mostly about suspension. I think we have Ride Tech.
Cool.
Is going to call in and talk to us.
Yeah, I think we got Brett Fokel, the CEO of the company, is going to call in and talk to us and see what they're up to. But anyways, we want to thank you for joining us this weekend. And, you know, if you're in Del Mar and you happen to get out there, we have a truck, the Orange 56 with the blown 392 Hemi out there at the California Car Cover. Go visit them.
So that's where you've been. I should have known I'd find you in the garage with Bodie Stroud.